a pretty good idea of how climate change will affect the world, but what about the people in it? How will it affect us? Hey guys, Tara here for DNews, and we've been talking a lot lately about climate change and how it's going to affect the world around us. Like everything though, there are unexpected consequences, and according to a new study, one of the consequences of climate change is fewer males being born. It sounds crazy, but this has actually been happening over in Japan. Researchers from the M&K Health Institute have been examining how extreme weather events have affected sex ratios of infants in Japan. Specifically, they looked at temperature fluctuations brought on by global warming and compared them to national data on births and fetal deaths between 1968 and 2012. Fetal deaths being any miscarriage that occurs after 12 weeks of gestation. And what they found is that male fetuses are considerably more vulnerable to extreme weather, which has led to a decrease in the amount of male births. In 2010, Japan experienced their hottest summer since 1898 when records began. During that summer, researchers noted an increase in the number of miscarriages, and 9 months later, they also noticed a decrease in the ratio of male to female babies born in the country, meaning the majority of those miscarriages were male. But it's not just the heat that causes this. The following year, in 2011, Japan also experienced a particularly brutal winter. And sure enough, that winter saw an increase in miscarriages and a subsequent decrease in male births 9 months later. Researchers say this doesn't necessarily mean that climate change is completely to blame here, but it does highlight the fact that male fetuses in particular are extremely sensitive to external stress factors. Earthquakes, pollution, and even famine have all been linked to increased miscarriages and a decline in the number of male births. What's especially damning about this study, though, is the exact timing of events. It pretty clearly indicates that temperature is at least partially responsible, and unfortunately, no one's really been able to explain why this is such a male-specific problem. What do you guys think? Any plausible theories you want to throw out there? If so, just leave them in the comments below. Otherwise, thanks for watching.